The Philippines bracing for Super Typhoon Mawar. It is now heading towards northern Luzon after battering Guam. Mawar is forecast to remain a super typhoon when it enters the Philippine area of responsibility either tonight or Saturday morning. Let's get more details from State Weather Bureau forecaster Dan Villamil. Hi Dan, go ahead.
Good afternoon, Mini, and to our viewers here at ANC. As of 3 a.m. today, the center of the eye of Super Typhoon Mawar was located at 1,740 kilometers east of southeastern Luzon. It has maximum sustained winds of 215 kilometers per hour near the center and gustiness of up to 265 kilometers per hour. It is moving westward at 20 kilometers per hour and is expected to enter the Philippine area of responsibility this evening until tomorrow morning. As of the moment, the southwesterly wind flow is currently bringing cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over Zamboanga Peninsula, northern Mindanao, Sokcharjen, and Bangsamoro. Here in Metro Manila and the rest of the country, we expect generally fair weather conditions with chances of localized thunderstorms in the afternoon to evening. Temperature forecast for Metro Manila for today will be from 24 to 33 degrees Celsius. 17 to 25 degrees for Baguio City and 25 to 33 degrees Celsius for Legazpi City. There is no gale warning currently in effect over any seaboards of our country, but in the coming days, issuance of gale warning is not or is possible over the eastern seaboards of Luzon due to the track of incoming Super Typhoon Mawar. That will be all for the weather report for today. Dan Villamil reporting.
Thank you very much, Dan. They're joining us from Pag-asa. The Philippine government now on an all-hands-on-deck approach for Super Typhoon Mawar. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. says he has made sure funds and food packs are pre-positioned. Response teams are also now on standby. Marcos also says local government units are ready in areas that may be affected by Mawar. As part of government preparations for Super Typhoon Mawar, the Metropolitan Manila Development Authority puts on standby its search and rescue teams. Rescue equipment like life vests and fiberglass and rubber boats are also now ready for deployment. The MMDA also monitoring flood-prone areas.
Ito pong parating na bagyo, masasabi natin na blessing po ito at a curse. Blessing dahil may dala po itong tubig. Hopefully mapuno yung ating mga dams at makakatulong po ito na ma-mitigate yung posibleng epekto ng El Nino. Pero pwede rin po ito maging curse dahil kung sobra naman po ang dami ng tubig na dadalhin na itong bagyo na ito ay pwede po magdulot ng pagbaha. At ganoon din po yung hangin dahil ito po ay medyo malakas.
Meanwhile, the Philippine Coast Guard will strictly enforce a no-sail policy.
Kasama din po yung pag-proactive na pag-deploy po natin in advance. We have references kung saan po madalas nangyayari yung mga baha kung sakasakali. At inatasan na po natin yung ating mga units na kahit na way before the rains come in, meron ng deployment in advance. Mga barko naman po natin at mga small boats, nare-refuel na po siya by this time para po it will be response ready by the time it's needed.